स्वेच्छाकेसरिणः स्वच्छस्वच्छाय आयासितेन्दवः त्रायन्ताम्बूमुद्रिपोः प्रपन्नार्तिच्छदो नकाः रसाक्षिप्ततया यस्य बन्धशक्यक्रियो भवेत् अपृथग्यत्ननिर्वर्त्यः सो अलङ्कारो ध्वनौ मतः. इन् ध्वनि विच् इस् द ध्वनि आत्मभूतरसः इन् देट् द अलङ्कारं शुड् बि अपृथग्यत्ननिर्वर्त्यः. देट्स् वेरि इम्पार्टेण्ट् एस् ऐ टोल्ड् यु in the last class. So he, after a few karikas, Anandavardhana actually gives some rules how alankaras should be used in a rasadhvani place, how they can without any trouble or without any vighnam for rasa aswadha, the alankaras have to be used in such a manner. सो रस आक्षिप्ततया एव यस्य अलङ्कारस्य बन्धः शक्यक्रियः भवेत्. रस आक्षिप्ततया रसबन्धाय अनुकूलतया यथा वर्तते तथा अलङ्कारस्य बन्धः क्रियते. एण्ड् इट् शुड् आल्सो बी लैक् देर् शुड् बि नो एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट् सीन् वेन् अ पोयट् हेस् रिटन् अ श्लोकम्. यु शुड् नाट् द अलङ्कारं शुड् नाट् बि द फस्ट् थिङ्ग् दट् हिट्स् यु. अपृथग् यत्नः पृथक् यत्नेन न निर्वर्त्यः भवति. इट् शुड् नाट् बि यूस्ड् वित् एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट् इन् सच् अ मेनर् देट् ओन्ली दि अलङ्कार इस् सीन् बै अस्. इन्स्टेड् आफ् देट् इट् शुड् जस्ट् फ्लो एण्ड् इट् शुड् बि मोर् इन् अकार्डन्स् वित् द रसम्. जस्ट् लैक् हौ कपोले पत्राली, दिस् इस् जस्ट् एन् एक्साम्पल् देट् हि गिव्स्. But slowly he is also going to give us how in certain cases how it should be taken, kale tyagaha, kale grahanam and all that. So this is a samanya udaharanam that he gives for how an alankara should just automatically come with the flow of the shloka. Kapole patrali karatala nirodhena mridita nipito nishwasaihi ayam amritakrityo adhara rasaha मुहुः कण्ठे लग्नः तरलयति बाष्पः बाष्पस्तनतटीं प्रियो मन्युर्जातः तव निरनुरोधे न तु वयम्. हे निरनुरोधे, निरनुरोधे अनुरोधः इस् दया, निरनुरोधे दयारहिते यु आर् वेरि क्रूयल् निर्दये. दिस् एङ्गर् तव मन्युः प्रियः जातः. यु हेव् सो मच् आफ् एङ्गर् हियर्. नायक इस् he has actually made a mistake, aparadha kantaha, and he is asking her to be nice to him, whereas she is very angry. At the same time she is also crying, she regrets. So here it's actually an isha vipralambha shloka, and the nayaka uses chatu ukti to say that your anger seems to be more dear to you than me. वयं न तु वयं, मन्युः तव प्रियः जातः. प्रियः जातः, प्रियः मीन्स् मोर् इट् इस् डियर् एण्ड् आल्सो बिलवेड् लैक् अ कान्तः. कान्तः जातः मन्युः, न तु वयम्, अहं तु तव कान्तः नास्मि. हौ इस् देट्? सो ही इस् डिस्क्रैबिङ्ग् हर् नौ. कपोले पत्राणि करतलनिरोधेन मृदिता, करतलनिरोधेन कपोले करतलनिरोधेन पत्राली मृदिता. द डिज़ैन्स् दट् यु वेर् आर् द मेकप् दट् यु हेव् आन् युर् चीक्स्, कपोले टू आफ् युर् चीक्स् हेज् अ पत्राली. देर् आर् सम् डिज़ैन्स् इन् द शेप् आफ् अ पत्रम् दट् हेस् बीन् मृदिता. इट् हेस् बीन् इरेस्ड् फ्रम् युर् चीक्स्. वै? बिकास् यु सो अप्सेट् एण्ड् यु आर् हेविङ्ग् युर् हेण्ड् आन् युर् चीक्स्. करतलनिरोधेन, because you have your hand on your cheek. Kara kisalayam nyasta vadana. I'll just read what is there in the lochanam also parallelly. So kara kisalaya nyasta vadana esha nayika. So what happens? Karatala nirodhena, because you have placed your hands on your cheek. Kapole patrali mridita, it's only one, not kapola dvayam. So only on one cheek you have kept your hand. So if you keep like this, it is not dukkham. So only imagine, when you are very sad. Tamil la we have this, kappal kavandalo kannathil kai vekka kudadimba. It's one paramuri or popular saying. Even if the kappal means boat, even if the boat has capsized, you don't keep your hand on your cheek, which means you don't feel down and depressed. You have to get back into shape. You don't just get bogged down by the dukkham that you have. So Kapole, what is this Naika doing? Kapole patrali mridita karatala nirodhena. Next is because chinta yukta, she's thinking about, oh, what am I going to do? You know, I've shown anger. Now she has so much of garvam that she doesn't want to go back. She's also angry and jealous that this person has maybe said someone else's name, or some small aparadham could also be there. Something he did not listen to her. It may not be something like cheating. It could be just a small thing, like she was trying to explain something and he didn't consider it. He was looking at some other work or something like that, some aparadha. So she's thinking now how to go back, rectify the situation. So Kapole patrali mridita kimartham karatala nirodhena, because her hands have been placed on her cheeks. Next is nishwasaihi adhara amrita hriddeha adhara rasaha nipitaha. This is also, see, her anger is so dear to her. It's like the anger is one nayaka. Manyuho krodhaha atra nayaka rupena tasyaha kapole karatalam nikshipya patrali mridita. So if a nayaka is trying to, you know, appease the nayika, how he would keep the hand on her cheeks and, you know, try to talk to her, so that makeup could have also been erased by that. So he's imagining the There is a sambhavana that the manyu is like a nayaka. That's why he's saying manyuhu tava manyuhu priyaha tava jataha. He has become tava priyaha jataha. It has become like one nayaka for you. So kapole patrali karatala nirodhena mridita. Next is nipitaha adhara rasaha nipitaha. Katham nishwasaihi. Nishwasaihi, because you are sighing, the outward appearance is this, physical appearance is this, nishwasaihi. Your deep sighing or deep breath, you're taking in and letting out deep sighs. That amrita, that has removed the color in your lips. Adhara rasaha, amrita hrityaha, adhara rasaha. The aswadaha, adhara aswadaha, amrita iva hrityaha asti. It is so attractive like nectar, and the lips are faded because of you sighing constantly and letting out breath. It'll fade, right? Because it doesn't have that moisture, so it'll immediately lose that moisture and the color of that adharam will change. Here, he's writing, using the words in such a manner. He says, nishwasaihi, nishwasena, adhara rasaha, nipitaha. The lips, it has been drunk. It's as if the wind has drunk the color of your lips, or the rasam of the lips. Nishwasaihi amrita hridyaha adhara rasaha nipitaha. It's again like a priya who is trying to kiss. So it is the manyuhu eva tava priyaha jataha natu vayam. I have not been able to approach you or kiss you, but it is that manyu or that kopaha that is adhara rasaha nipitaha. Kopena tava adhara rasaha nipitaha. Muhuhu kante lagnaha bashpastanatatim taralayati. Muhuhu kante lagnaha. Kante lagnaha, it is there. Now we say that anger and those tears are constantly in the throat. It is not, I'm not able to swallow that anger. There are so many expressions that we use even in English, right? That anger is still there in the throat. So she's feeling angry at the neck. So she's feeling angry at the same time, or she's controlling her bashpam, tears. She's trying not to let that tears down. So which means she's controlling it. And because of that, she's so... her bosoms are taralayati. It's also drenched with bashpam. Either she has let go of the tears beforehand, or after that anger, she is crying so much that her chest is drenched with tears, and taralayati kampayuktam asti. It's also shivering. Now imagine, it is the kopaha is like a nayaka who is embracing her, kanthe lagnaha. He is embracing her at the neck. And Bashpas tanatatim taralayati. He is also, because of that embrace, her chest is also heaving. She's, so because of her nishwasam and all that, she's feeling that passion. So there's so much of going on here. It's as if the Nayaka is very jealous of that Manyu, that Kopaha is more dear to her, and she is embracing that Kopam than him, more than him. So the Irshya Vipralambam is actually that which the Nayaka is feeling towards the Nayika. He feels that she is giving more attention to the anger and not to him. He has to receive more affection, the attention from the Nayika. The words in Lochana are very nice. Kara Kisalaya Nyastavadana. It just is a, summarizes the whole shlokam in a very beautiful manner. Kara Kisalaya Nyastavadana. Her hands are placed on her face. So she, her face is placed on her hand. Shwasa Tanta Adhara Tanta Mlana. By the shwasa, her lips are very klanta, it's very faded. And then pravartamana bashpa bhara niruddha kanti. Her tears are slowly coming, but it is she's trying very hard to stop her tears. She doesn't want to appear weak in front of that man. She wants to show that anger so that he feels regret. Huh? So niruddha kanti, she has stopped the tears, the heavy tears. Bashpa bhara, it's not just one, you know, one tear is dropping, not like that. She's got so much of she's so upset that she's controlled her flow of tears, and so her you know, niruddha kanti so muhuhu kanthe lagnaha. She has explained it like that. Avichinna rudita chanchat kuchatata. And she's constantly not crying out, but in she's crying inside. So because of that, her stanatati kuchatatam chanchat asti, chanchalatvam asti kuchatate. Rosham aparityajanti, she's not able to let go of her anger. Chatu uktya yavat prasadyate, as she is being cajoled by the Nayaka with a chatu ukti, in a very pleasing manner, he is trying to tell her, you seem to give more attention to the krodham. Tavat irshya vipralambhagata anubhava charvana avahita chetasaha. Here that irshya vipralambham is there for both the Nayaka. Nayaka is only, it is only a chatu ukti for him. It is not so much of an Ishriya Vipralamba for the Nayaka as it is for the Nayika. Nayika's Anubhava are all these. Anubhava is her actions which she feels because she is jealousy. See, she has jealous and the Nayaka has done a mistake. So she is jealous that he has gone and he's cheated on her. That Irshya. So she has kopam. Irshya Vipralamba is not only jealous, it is also a display of anger when the Nayaka is trying to placate her, cajole her. Okay. So Irshya Vipralambagata Anubhava Charvana Avahita Chetasaha Vaktuhu. This Vakta also has that Irshya Vipralambam, where he wants to say that you are giving more attention to the anger. So Vaktragata Irshya Vipralambha Anubhavaha. Okay, actually, what he's trying to say here is the Nayika is displaying Irshya Vipralambha. This Nayaka Vakta is trying to understand that Irshya Vipralambham. And he is also using Irshya here, Asuya here, to convey his idea, you know, his wish that she will let go of that Vipralambham and talk to him. Yeah. Eva, now we are looking at Alankaram here. So Aprita Gyartna Nirvartyaha. We've seen how the shloka is beautifully displayed here, is, you know, described here. But the Alankaram that are involved here are Rupaka and Vyatireka. Shlesha, Rupaka, Vyatireka. I'm trying to find out where this Shlesha is. I think it should be कण्ठे लग्नः मीन्स् आलिङ्गनरूपः अपि अस्ति, कण्ठे लग्नः कण्ठे निरुद्धः बाष्पः इति बाष्पभरः, देट् कुड् बी द यु नो एण्ड् प्रियः, प्रियः मीन्स् डियर् टु वन् एण्ड् कान्तः इत्यपि, कामी अथवा कान्तः कामुकः इत्यपि तत्र श्लेषेन द्व्यर्थकः शब्दः, सो देट् आल्सो केन् बि टेकन्. रूपकम् इस् अदिन् अधररसः इस् रूपकम्, अमृतहृद्यः अमृतम् अमृतहृद्यः अधररसः, अधररसः अमृत अमृतमिव हृद्यः, दट् इस् उपमालङ्कारम्. ऐ डोण्ट् नो वै हि इस् मेन्शन्ड् रूपकं हियर्, ऐ वास् ट्रैङ्ग् टु थिङ्क् अबौट् इट्, ऐ डिन्ट् गेट्. सो that's why it is apritam yatna, whether you look at this alankaram or not, it is that rasa that is first and foremost in this shloka, more than the alankaras. So the alankaras just fall in place without any great effort to highlight those alankaras. The highlight is only for the irsha vipralambam. So priyo manyuho jatah na tu vayam, we are not close to you, or we are not priya for you, I am not a priya for you, it is only the manyu that is the kopam, the krodha that is dear to you. Here there is a vyatirekam where the upama, he is comparing himself to the krodha, the nayaka is comparing himself to the krodha, and he is saying that the krodha manyu is one step better than me. So upamanam or the upameyam, one of those two, if there is a comparison between two things and one is shown to be better, then it is vyatireka alankaraha, there is a difference that is being shown. So that is also another alankaram that is here. So rupaka shlesha rupaka vyatirekadyaha ayatna nishpannaha, without any great special effort those alankaras have been used here. बट् चर्वयितुः अपि न रसचर्वणा विघ्नं आददति, रसचर्वणा विघ्नं, देर् इस् नो ओब्स्टिकल् फोर् मी टु एन्जाय् दट् रसम्, ऐ डोण्ट् गेट् बेक् टु द सेम्, सी हौ ब्यूटिफुलि हि हेस् यूस्ड् व्यतिरेक अलङ्कारं हियर्, नो इट्स् मोर् टु डू वित् द चाटु उक्ति आफ् द नायक, द वे हि एक्स्प्लेन्स् इट्, the way he describes the irshya vipralamba anubhava, and there is a irshya vipralamba rasasya charvana asti natu alankarasya charvana vartate. I hope you understand that. Okay, kapole patrali karatala nirodhena mridita nipito nishwasaihi ayam amrita hrudyo adhara rasaha muhukkante lagnaha तरलयति बाष्पस्तनतटीं प्रियो मन्युर्जातः तव निरनुरोधे न तु वयम्. देर् इस् अ बिग् कारिका पोर्शन् हियर्, सारि वृत्ति पोर्शन् हियर्. रस अङ्गत्वे च तस्य लक्षणम् अपृथग्यत्ननिर्वर्त्यम् इति, सो द लक्षणं फार् रस अङ्गत्वे तस्य लक्षणं, रस अङ्गत्वे हौ शुड् अलङ्कार बि एम्प्लाय्ड् एज़् एन् अङ्ग टु रसम्, दट् इस् एज़् एन् अङ्ग टु रस अलङ्कार इस् डिफैन्ड् एस् अपृथग्यत्न निर्वर्त्यम्, दट्स् वेरि इम्पार्टेण्ट्. सो अपृथग्यत्न निर्वर्त्यं विदौट् एनी एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट् इट् इस् यूस्ड्, यो रसं बन्धुम् अध्यवसितस्य कवेः अलङ्कारः तां वासनाम् अत्युह्य यत्नान्तरम् आस्थितस्य निष्पद्यते सः न रस अङ्गम् इति. इन् प्लेसस् वेर् कवि गोस् बियाण्ड् हिस् वासना, रसं बन्धुम् अध्यवसितस्य कवेः, कवि हिस् गोल् इस् टु रैट् अ काव्यं विच् हेज् रसम् एस् अङ्गि और् प्रधानम्, यत्र रसं प्रधानतया बन्धुं प्रयत्नं करोति यत्र कविः. सो वाट् डस् ही डू, रसं बन्धुम् अध्यवसितस्य कवेः अलङ्कारः यः अस्ति, तादृशकवेः अलङ्कारः, वाट् डस् ही डू, वासनां, तां वासनाम् अत्यूह्य, रसं बन्धुम् अलङ्कारः, विच् मीन्स् रसम् अङ्गितया बन्धुं यः प्रयत्नं करोति तत्र अलङ्कारः अङ्गत्वेनैव निवेश्यः. बट् वाट् तां वासनाम् अत्यूह्य, ही क्रासस् दट् वासना आर् दट् संस्कारं दट् ही हेस्, ही गोस् बियाण्ड् दट् संस्कारम् and then he makes an extra effort to think about the different alankaras that he has studied. He takes Kuvalayanandam, he starts ticking off. Okay, I have used Upama in the first shlokam. I have used Rupakam in the fifth shloka. Apannuti, oh, that one, Kaitava Apannuti, I have used in the 31st shloka. Like that, if he starts ticking off alankaras from an alankara shastra and makes an effort to use, employ each and every alankaram in his kavyam, then there is no rasa angatvam there. That becomes the pradhanam there, right? So yamakecha, especially in shabdalankara, uses of shabdalankara, we see yamakecha prabandhena buddhipurvakam kriyamane niyamenaiva yatnantara parigraha apatati shabda vishesha anveshana rupaha. So shabda vishesha anveshana rupaha yatnantara parigraha apatati niyamenaiva. By default, when you are trying to use Yamaka in a Prabandha, in a Kavyam, when you are trying to use Yamaka in a Kavyam, buddhipurvakam kriyamane. It is not a natural process where the words just come and fall. In Yamakam, you are trying to search for the words. Right? Shabda visheshanam anveshana rupaha yatnaha tatra asti eva niyamena asti. बुद्धिपूर्वकं क्रियमाणे नियमेनैव बै डिफाल्ट् यत्नान्तर परिग्रहः. यत्नान्तर मीन्स् एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट्. एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट् इस् डेफिनेट्लि टेकन् टु फैण्ड् औट् दट् स्पेसिफिक् वर्ड्. इफ् ऐ हाव् टु यूस् तमसां प्राप तमसामपि ऐ कीप् फर्गेटिङ्ग् दट् श्लोकम्. Tamas is the word that he wants to use. There is no great Purana reference. See, Ganga is very, Ganga is famous for removing tamas, tamogunam, or removing papa. But tamasa is not a nadi which is known or prasiddham to remove tamas. But Bhojaraja has used it in his Champuramayanam to specifically bring out that which is not a Purana prasiddham also. It is just to show his ruchi for Yamakam in that shlokam. So there is an extra effort used. He searches for such words and employs it in that shlokam. So Yamakecha prabandena buddhipurvakam kriyamane नियमेनैव. वन् मिनिट्. बुद्धिपूर्वकं प्रबन्धेन, ओके, प्रबन्धः, वाट् ही वाण्ट्स् टु सी हियर् इस् इन् काव्यं न प्रबन्धेन क्रियमाणः इति सम्बन्धः कर्तव्यः. सो बुद्धिपूर्वकं प्रबन्धेन क्रियमाणे यमके सति. यमके क्रियमाणे सति प्रबन्धेन मीन्स् आग्रहेण. इट् टेक्स् दट् मीनिङ्ग्, नाट् इन् अ काव्यं. सो वेन् अ पोयट् वाण्ट्स् टु यूस् यमक वित् अ प्रबन्ध मीन्स् वित् अ ग्रेट् एफर्ट् वित् अ ग्रेट् आग्रहम् I have to use, like how, you know, in Paduka Sahasram, you have the Chitra Paddhati where he wanted to show his prowess in that Padma Bandha, etc., etc. So, Niyameyanaiva Yatnantara Parigraha Apatati, because he has to search for such special words. Alankarantara Varge, Alankarantareshu Api Tattulyam Iti Chet. Now, this is the Purupakshi is asking. So just like how in Yamaka you make a special effort, I can also have the list of Alankaras and वाचं निशम्य भगवान् स तु नारदस्य प्राचेतस प्रकटम् तमसां तमसां निहन्त्रीं तमसां निहन्त्रीं दट् इस् द वर्ड् करेक्ट् काण्टेक्स्ट् ओके वाचं निशम्य भगवान् स तु नारदस्य प्राचेतस प्रवचसां प्रथमः कवीनां माद्यन्दिनायन यमाय महर्षिसेव्यां पुण्याम् अवाप तमसां तमसां निहन्त्रीम् he attained tamasa river punyam avapa tamasam tamasam nihantrim, one who removes the tamas tamogunam in everybody. सो दट् तमोगुण निहन्त्री इति प्रसिद्धं न वि आल् नो गङ्गा यमुना एण्ड् दट् गङ्गा यमुना सङ्गमं प्रयागम् इस् वेरि इम्पार्टेण्ट् सो हि हेस् स्पेसिफिक्लि सर्च्ड् फार् दट् वर्ड् एण्ड् हि हेस् डन् दिस् रैट् सो अलङ्कारान्तरेषु अपि तत् तुल्यम् इति चेत् ईवन् फार् अदर् अर्थालङ्कारास् लेट्स् हाव् ए लिस्ट् लैक् दट् एण्ड् यु नो देर् इस् एन् एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट् दट् अ कवि हेस् टु पुट् लेट् इट् बी लैक् दट् मीन्स् इट्स् नाट् नाट् सो मच् बिकास् अर्थं इट् इस् ओन्ली बेस्ड् आन् दि अर्थं दट् वी हाव् वाच्यार्थ दट् वि गो टु द व्यङ्ग्यार्थ सो हेज् यु ट्रै टु कन्स्ट्रक्ट् द वाच्यार्थ बेस्ड् आन् रसम् with a view that this vachyartha should give me rasam, automatically certain alankaras will just fall in place. The kavi does not need to put in a special effort. Whereas shabda vishesham, you need those specific words, and shabda alankara is something where shabda parivritti asahatvam is there. So in the sense, you cannot change the words there. Instead of tamasam, I cannot say andhakaranam nihantrim, then the yamaka alankara itself is not there. So because there is a focus on the shabda, the poet also has to focus on the words that he has to employ to get yamaka alankara. Whereas in other alankaras, it is not the same. Tattulyam iti chet na evam. Alankarantareshu yamaka tulyam nasti kimartham. अलङ्कारान्तराणि हि निरूप्यमाणदुर्घटनानि अपि रससमाहितचेतसः प्रतिमानवतः कवेः अहं पूर्विकया परापतन्ति इम्पोर्टेण्ट् सो अलङ्कारान्तराणि दि अदर् अलङ्कारास् हौ आर् दे निरूप्यमाणदुर्घटनानि अपि देर् इस् लैक् इन् दिस् कपोले पत्राणि वि वर् ट्रैन् टु अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् विच् वन् इस् रूपकं देर् whether it is rupakam or upama or where is the shlesha we were trying to look for that shlesha there nirupyamana durghatanani even if there is a difficulty in trying to justify what alankara is there in this shloka there may be shlokas where you will have to think like in that adenna kavi prakasham in the first you would have seen punah kwapi यः कौमारहरः स एव वरः ता एव चैत्रक्षपाः इन् दट् श्लोकम् यु विल् फैण्ड् दट् दे वर् ट्रैङ्ग् रियलि हार्ड् टु ब्रिङ्ग् इन् विशेषोक्ति एण्ड् विभावना अलङ्कार इट् वास् वेरि डिफिकल्ट् टु ब्रिङ्ग् इन् दट् अलङ्कारं निरूप्यमाण दुर्घटनानि अपि बट् वाट् इस् देर् रससमाहितचेतसः द कवि हू हेड् रिटन् दट् श्लोक यः कौमारहरः हि हेज् हिस् मैण्ड् वास् फोकस्ड् आन् रसम् He wanted to show that nostalgia. He wanted to show that utkantha there, that vipralambham there. I am not able to enjoy it in the same manner. Reva rodhasi tarutale cheta samutkantate. I'm eagerly waiting to go back to that time and that place when my husband was still my lover. She wants to do that. So that is rasa samahita chetasaha kavehe pratibhanavataha. He has that extra creativity in him to write a shloka, which is rasapurvakam. So what happens for him? Kavehe alankarantarani anya arthalankarani. अन्ये अर्थालङ्काराः अहं पूर्विकया परापतन्ति अहं पूर्विका मीन्स् अहं पूर्वम् इति धावन्ति दे आटोमेटिक्लि कम् ऐ वाण्ट् टु कम् मोस्ट् शाकुन्तलं श्लोकं यु विल् फैण्ड् दट् यु नो at the first reading you will only want to enjoy the shlokam it's so beautiful the rasam is so nice whether it is vipralambha or the shringara rasam you will want to enjoy the shloka first And then, we also, you know, there is an exam to write. Let us look at the alankaras and we will go to the alankaras later. But those alankaras will just fall in place so beautifully with the shlokam that it is only the rasa that has pradhanam in those shlokas. So, alankarantarani, nirupyamana durghatanani, even if it is difficult to justify those alankaras, because the poet has his focus on the rasam, एंड ही हैज ए क्रिएटिविटी प्रतिभानवतः कवेः अलंकारांतराणि अहं पूर्विकया परापतन्ति बिकम एंड फॉल यथा कादंबर्याम कादंबरी दर्शन अवसरे we can't take examples because neither Lochanam nor any of the vyakhyatas have given such examples. There is one huge paragraph where he sees Kadambari and there is a description about Kadambari. Many different alankaras are used, but it is just an outpouring of Chandrapeeda when he looks at Kadambari and she is standing there. It's something that we have to read, and it is one whole big paragraph gadya portion which is very difficult to bring some examples here. यथा च माया राम शिरोदर्शनेन विह्वलायां सीतादेव्यां सेतौ सेतुबन्ध इज अनदर काव्यम वेर सीता द मोमेंट शी सीज माया राम शिरः द बिहेडेड रामा it is actually a maya rupam that ravana or indrajit comes and shows it to sita and she is very upset on seeing that and she, there are alankaras which is come and fall in place but the karuna rasam is more prominent so yuktam cha etat yataha rasaha vachya visheshaih eva akshiptavyah that is the key point here the key is Why is it that in Arthalankaras, you don't need a special Shabda Vishesha Anveshana or Yatnantara Parigraha Nasti Arthalankaranam Ityukte Tatra Yuktam Cha? Because Yataha Rasaha Rasa is based off of Vyachya Visheshaihi Eva Akshiptavyaha. Akshiptavyaha, it has to be suggested only by the Vachyartha. We need the primary meaning. We don't need the primary word here. I can use any other word, right? Yah kaumaraharaha sayeva varaha. I can use any other words for those things. For those kaumaraharaha or varaha, chaitra kshapaha. Instead of chaitra kshapaha, I can use chaitra ratryaha. Whatever it may be. The words can be changed, but the artham, vachyartham, that from the primary meaning only, we get the rasa, which is the vengyartham. So the primary meaning is important. So the Arthalankaras automatically come and follow. And there is no restriction to whether this Arthalankara should not be. See, when we were talking about how Shringare Yamakam we have to avoid. Sarvatha Parihartavyam Karune Vipralambeja. Because it is the Sukumarata that needs to be highlighted. Whereas there is no such restrictions in this. The restrictions are how you have to use the alankara. That is where the restriction is. That he will talk about later. So, yuktam cha etat yataha rasaha vachya visheshaihi eva akshetavyaha tat pratipadakaischa shabdaihi tat prakashinaha vachya visheshaha eva rupakadayaha alankaraha tat pratipadakaihi shabdaihi. The shabda, which is the words which are important to give me the primary meaning, or the alankara. So tat pratipadakaihi shabdaihi, tat pratipadakaihi rasa pratipadakaihi shabdaihi. Only those words which help me for rasa pratipadaka. Which means you will have madhurya, soft letters for shungaram, harsh letters for raudram, then all those rules will come into play. So tat pratipadakaihi shabdaihi, tat prakashinaha vachya visheshaha eva, rupakadayaha alankaraha. So rupaka alankara, can appear rupaka etc which means all the arthalankaras can occur in a rasasthalam only if they have words and artha vachyartha which are tat prakashinaha and tat pratipadaka means rasa pratipadakaihi shabdaihi eva rasa prakashinaha vachya visheshaihi these two combined to give us the rupaka etc alankaras tasmat न तेषां बहिरंगत्वं रस अभिव्यक्तौ सो रस अभिव्यक्तौ when there is a bahirangam means they need not be removed when there is a rasa abhivyakti sthalam so yamaka duskara margeshu tu tat sthitam eva yattu rasavanti tu angita eva सारी यत्तु रसवन्ति कानिचित् यमकादीनि दृश्यन्ते तत्र रसादीनाम् अङ्गता यमकादीनां तु अङ्गिता एव यमक दुष्करमार्गेषु दुष्करमार्गम् इस् चित्रबन्धं पद्मबन्धम् एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा आल् दोस् आर् काल्ड् दुष्करमार्ग यमक दुष्करमार्गेषु तु तत् स्थितमेव इत्युक्ते अङ्गत्वं स्थितमेव So, when there is an alankara, in a shlokam, when there is an alankara and there is a rasam also, pradhanataya yatra bhasate, tatra tesham alankaranam bahirangatvam rasa abhivyaktau. Oh, no, no, no. 1 minute. Tasmat na tesham bahihi angatvam rasa abhivyaktau. Haan, correct, dhane? Yeah. I said correctly only. I got confused. Yamaka dushkara margeshu tu tat sthitameva. This arthalankara rules, whatever rules that we are talking about, you know, that is there. It's not there for alankaras, but in yamaka, etc., that rule, he just reiterates that yamake niyamena yatnyantara parigraha asti eva tasmat yamakeshu tat sthitam. Ityukte, the rule that we are talking about, how You know, there is a prithag yatnam and that rule still stays in Yamaka. He is just connecting it to the earlier sentence. Okay. Yattu. Now, this is a separate portion now from Yattu. Yattu rasavanti kanichit yamaka yamakadini drishyante. In some places, a poet may have used Yamakam, but there is a rasapurvakam also there. I'm able to enjoy the rasam also. A Sahirdaya can enjoy the rasa. There is a Yamaka also. There are some places like that. Maybe in Kalidasa, you will find in Shishupalavadha, Sixth Sarga, and all these places, you have certain words that they have used, which is there is a Yamaka Pradhanam also. At the same time, the shlokas are also rasavanti. Enjoyable too. What do I do in those thalams? Tatra rasadinam angata. No matter what, if you see Yamakam, then the rasam, even rasadinam, ityukte shringara, hasya, karuna, veera, raudra, all of those. So even in raudra rasam and veera rasam, if there is Yamaka, then that Yamakam, shabdalankara, etc., makes the rasam as angam actually. In chanchad bhuja bhramita, if you closely look at it, there is no anuprasa there. There is actually no Shabdalankara. If you go with the rules of Shabdalankaram, Anuprasa, Bhuja, Brahmita, there is only a sound, repetition of sound. There is no repetition of consonants or repetition of a consonant combination. Because Bhuja is Bha and U, Ukara is there. Brahmita is actually Bha, Ra and A. So there is no continuity or there is no repetition of a set of consonants or vowels there. Actually, there is no anuprasam in the chancha bhuja bhramita. You will not find it. So if that rasa has to be pradhanam, then you cannot have yamaka. If there is a yamaka, then yamakadinam tu angita eva. Only that yamaka is pradhanam. Because the first thing you read in a shloka is the words before you even go into the artha. The first thing that slaps your face is the words. Only after looking at the word, you are going to understand the meaning and then go to the vachyartha. If the word itself has these yamaka and etc. shabdalankaras, then that will always gain prominence even after you get to the rasa. Rasa bhase cha angatvam. He makes a distinction here and says, in rasas, yamaka is pradhanam, rasa angatam apnoti. Rasa bhase tu angatvam api abiruddham. I don't mind yamaka in rasa bhasa. Yamakas can exist in rasa bhasam and rasa bhasa can be angi, yamaka can become angam. There, why he says is rasabhasa itself is not completely rasam. It is rasa eva abhasate. So it's only an ishat भासते. देर् इस् ओन्लि अ स्लैट् शेड् आफ़् शृङ्गारम् आर् अ स्लैट् शेड् आफ़् वीर रौद्र एक्सेट्रा. सो इन् रसाभासम् ऐ केन् अलौ यमक. अङ्गितया तु व्यङ्ग्ये रसे न अङ्गत्वं पृथक् प्रयत्न निर्वर्त्यं निर्वर्त्यत्वात् यमकादेः. यमकादेः व्यङ्ग्ये रसे तु अङ्गितया हि इट् इस् जस्ट् अ रेपिटेशन् आफ् दट्. As I said, it's just an argumentative way of writing. So he yamakadi naam tu angita eva, he again repeats it. Vyangye rase, when rasa is vyangya, then yamaka is angitaya eva yamakadehe. Why? Na angatvam, they do not have an angam. Yamaka is pradhanam, yamaka is not subordinate, because prithak prayatna nirvartyatvat. The reason he says for that here is, पृथग् यत्न पृथक् प्रयत्नः यत्नान्त परिग्रहः अस्ति एव. किमर्थ शब्द अन्वेषणरूपः यत्नान्त अस्ति. हेन्स् इट् इस् नाट् अङ्ग, इट् इस् अन् अङ्गि, बिकास् द पोयेट् हेस् टर्न्ड् हिस् फोकस् आन् द वर्ड्स् इन् दट् श्लोक. पुण्याम् अवाप तमसां तमसां निहन्त्री. दट्स् मै इट् जस्ट् ऐ थिङ्क् दट्स् द बेस्ट् वे टु एक्स्प्लेन् दिस्. सो द सङ्ग्रहश्लोकाः अस्यैव अर्थस्य सङ्ग्रहश्लोकाः रसवन्तिः वस्तूनि सालङ्काराणि कथा कानिचित् एकेनैव प्रयत्नेन निर्वर्त्यन्ते महाकवेः. यमकादिनिबन्धे तु पृथग्यत्नोऽस्य जायते. शक्तस्यापि रसे अङ्गत्वं तस्मादेषां न विद्यते. रसाभास अङ्गभावस्तु यमकादेः न वार्यते. ध्वन्यात्मभूते शृङ्गारे तु अङ्गता नोपपद्यते. सो इन् कन्क्लूषन् दीस् आर् द four things that you can say from these shlokas. Rasavantihi vastuni kanichit salankarani ekainaiva prayatnena mahakavehe nirvartyante. Mahakavehe ekainaiva prayatnena nirvartyante salankarini salankarini salankarani rasavanti vastuni. When a poet tries to employ vastu katha vastu with alankara, बट् रसं रसपूर्णकथावस्तु यथा उत्पादयितुं प्रयत्नं करोति कविः, तथा एकेनैव प्रयत्नेन रसवन्ति कथावस्तूनि सालङ्काराणि कथावस्तूनि च करोति. हि डस् नाट् टेक् ए सेपरेट् एफर्ट् टु रैट्. सो एकेनैव प्रयत्नेन अलङ्काररसहितरसपूर्णकथावस्तु उत्पादयति कविः. ओके, नेक्स्ट् वन् इस् यमकादिनिबन्धे पृथग्यत्नः अस्य जायते. हि हेस् टु हेव् एन् एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट् फार् यमकादिनिबन्ध. शक्तस्यापि, शक्तस्यापि मीन्स् अ कवि, इट्स् नाट् दट् कालिदास केनाट् रैट्, बट् हि चोस् नाट् टु रैट्. इट्स् नाट् अ क्वश्चन् आफ् केपबिलिटि, इट् इस् अ क्वश्चन् आफ् चाय्स्. शक्तस्यापि प्रतिभायुक्तस्यापि महाकवेः यमकादिनिबन्धने विशेषप्रयत्नः जायते. सो इट् इस् बेटर् नाट् टु यूस् यमक, बिकास् शक्तस्यापि मीन्स् हि हेस् दट् क्रियेटिविटि, हि हेस् द केपबिलिटि, बट् हि प्रिफर्स् नाट् टु. तस्मात् एषाम् अङ्गत्वं न विद्यते. Hence, yamakadinam rase angatvam nasti, rase angitaya eva bhasante. Next is, rasabhasa angabhavastu yamakadehe na varyate. I'm okay if you use yamaka etc. in rasabhasa sthala. So, yamakadinam rasabhase angatvam bhavet. Tattu na varyate, I am not stopping that. Dvanyatmabhute shringare tu angata nopapadyate. If there is shringara rasam, then definitely, even in Raudra Rasam, any of those nine rasas, it is best to avoid Yamaka, etc. Especially Shringara Vipralamba Karuna. Remember how he used that gradation for Madhuryam? Use the same for that here also. Idanim Dvanyatma Bhutasya Shringarasya Vyanjakaha Alankara Vargaha Akhyayate. View? 9:40. Okay. ऐ डिडंट रियलाइज इज गोइंग सो स्लो सॉरी ध्वन्यात्मभूते शृङ्गारे समीक्ष्य विनिवेशितः रूपकादिः अलङ्कारवर्गः एति यथार्थताम् इदानीं सो फर् ही हेज़् नौ टॉक्ड अबौट् हेयवर्गं हेयवर्गं मीन्स् दट् विच् हेस् टु बि त्याज्यवर्गं दट् विच् हेस् टु बि अवाय्डेड् नौ ही इस् टेलिङ्ग् यू हौ टु यूस् दि अलङ्कारस् How not to use, we have learned. Now, when in the arrangement of Alankara Shastram, if you see in Kavya Prakasham, first he will talk about dosham, then he will go to the guna. The seventh ullasa is dosha prakaranam, the eighth ullasa is guna prakaranam. Before knowing the gunas, you have to first know what should be avoided. Kani parihartavyani iti prathamam jnatavya. Then we can go to what you have to employ. So he says, idanim, which means I have now told you how to avoid yamaka in certain rasadvanis. Now, dvanyatmabhutasya shringarasya vyanjakaha alankaravargaha akhyayate. What can be, those alankaras which can be used as a suggestors in shringararasam. Dvanyatmabhute shringare samikshya viniveshitaha alankaravargaha yatharthatam eti. It yatharthata charuta. Charutam eti. So, alankaraha hi. To understand, no? It's very simple. So, samikshya means you use an extra effort and use the alankara in an appropriate manner, then there is a charutvam there. Alankaraha hi bahya alankara samyat. Just like for a shariram, you have to use bahya alankaram in the same way. Anginaha charutva hetuhu uchyate. Alankaraha anginaha charutva hetuhu uchyate. आत्मनः यथा अलङ्कारः चारुत्वहेतुः अस्ति तथा अलङ्काराः अपि रसस्य चारुत्वहेतवः उच्यन्ते वाच्यालङ्कारवर्गः च रूपकादिः यावान् उक्तः वक्ष्यते च कैश्चित् अलङ्काराणाम् अनन्तत्वात् स सर्वः अपि यदि समीक्ष्य विनिवेश्यते तद् अलक्ष्यक्रमव्यङ्ग्यस्य ध्वनेः अङ्गिनः सर्वस्यैव चारुत्वहेतुः निष्पद्यते देर् मे बि इन्फिनिट् नम्बर् आफ़् अलङ्कारास् दट् हेव् बीन् यूस्ड् हेव् बीन् सेड् यु नो आर् विल् बि सेड् इफ् यु कौण्ट् द नम्बर् आफ़् अलङ्कारास् दट् हेव् बीन् डिस्क्रैब्ड् टिल् नौ देर् आर् सो मेनि यावान् उक्तः How many ever alankaras that have been said, vachyalankara vargaha, arthalankara vargaha, rupaka, etc. have been explained till now. Kaishchit vakshyate cha. Some may even come and say, you know, this is a different alankara that I have discovered. So you can keep discovering more and more alankaras. Alankaranam anantatvat. So even though there have been jewels that have been made, someone might come up with something very new. Right, which is not known before. So someone might come up with an alankara for the elbow, which we have not even used till now. Someone might invent a new type of alankaram. I'm talking about the bhushanam. In the same manner, there can come about a new alankara, which someone might discover. Sasarvaha api. I don't care, even if you bring about a new type of alankaram. Yadi samikshya viniveshyate. You take extra care and put it in that rasavat shlokam alakshyakrama vyangyasya anginaha sarvasya charutva hetu nishpadyate if it is used appropriately auchityam auchityena yadi upayujyate tarhi charutva hetu nishpadyate it can be beautiful the rules that he says for that are I will just finish with this esha cha asya viniveshane samiksha Angatva sadhanam. How can it? It's very easy to just say, you know, samikshya vinivesanam. You look at it appropriately. That will not explain it. He clearly states and tells us what are all the rules with which you have to employ the alankara in a rasadhvani place. Vivaksha tatparatvena nangitvena kadachana kaleja grahanatyago nati nirvahana ishita. Nirvyudhavapi changatve yatnena pratyavekshanam. रूपकादिरलङ्कारवर्गस्य अङ्गत्वसाधनम् रूपकादिरलङ्कारवर्गस्य अङ्गत्वसाधनम् वाट् आर् आल् द रूल्स् फस्ट् वन् विवक्षा तत्परत्वेन न अङ्गित्वेन कदाचन तत्परत्वेन रसपरत्वेन एव अलङ्काराणां विवक्षा यत्र भवति अङ्गित्वेन न कदाचन यत्र अलङ्काराः अङ्गितया न उच्यन्ते अथवा न विनिवेश्यन्ते तत्र तत्रैव रूपकादिवर्गस्य अङ्गत्वं यु केन् काल् दट् एस् अङ्ग ओन्ली वेन् इट् इस् रसपरत्वम् Then Kalecha Grahanam, Kalecha Tya. He's going to give examples for each and every one of these. Anandavardhana gives examples, Udaharanam. And Kale Grahanam, Uchita Avasare Upadanam. So, Uchita Avasare means as the, there are four lines in a shloka. The three lines, we saw that. Adena, and the, Kapole Patrali, Karatala Nirode Namritita, Nipito Nishwasaihi, I am Amrita Gridyo Rasaha. मुहुः कण्ठे लग्नः तरळयति बाष्पस्तनतटीं प्रियो मन्युर्जातः न तु वयं दट् व्यतिरेक अलङ्कार कम्स् एट् दि एण्ड् रैट् सो दिस् इस् नाट् एन् एक्साम्पल् फार् काले ग्रहणं जस्ट् टु टेल् यू हि इस् नाट् शोन् दट् व्यतिरेक अलङ्कार इन् एव्री ईच् एण्ड् एव्री लैन् इफ् हि हेड् शोन् इट् लैक् दट् देन् इट् बिकम्स् अति यु ट्रै टु अवाय्ड् एक्सेस् रैट् काले ग्रहणं Only at the correct time when there will be an effect, it's like a punchline. You can't have an entire dialogue with the punchline of punchlines, right? Punchline is singular. It has to come at the end. That is when it will have the most effect. So, Kale Grahanam. Kale Tyagaha. I'm trying to say, you know, Raktastvam Navapallavaihi. There is so much of Shlesha in that shlokam. He'll give that example. I think it is that Raktastvam Navapallavaihi. Ahamapi shlagyehi priyaya gunaihi. He will start off by saying, you know, giving the differences or equanimity between an Ashoka tree and himself. Purvarvas is talking in Vipralambam here in Viraha. He is separated from Urvashi and he starts. So he will be using that samyam, rupakam constantly and then suddenly he will let go of that. Kale tyagaha. To point out that tvam sarvam tulyam ashoka kevalam aham sashoka krutaha. You are Ashoka, you do not have any grief. Your name is Ashoka. Aham sashoka krutaha. I have been made with grief. So there he comes, kale tyagaha. Suddenly he drops that alankaram because it is not, if he had continued with the rupakam and everything, then it would have not been pointing to that sashokaha, that virahatvam will be lost. So kale tyagaha is also important. Na ati nirvahana ishita. As I said, you know, that vyatireka alankaram should not be there in all four lines. Then it is too much. Atyantam nirvodham naichati. Yam alankaram atyantam nirvodham naichati. Sayeva alankaraha angatvena manyate. The fifth rule for this is यत्ने निर्व्यूढावपि निर्वहे अपि या निर्वाहे अपि यत्नेन अंगत्वे प्रत्यवेक्षणम् यू शुड मेक एन एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट टू ओनली यूज दट अलंकार एज एन अंगम इवन इफ ही ट्राइज एन एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट टू पुट इन दट श्यामास्वंगम चकितहरिणी प्रेक्षणे दृष्टिपातः आई थिंक अदा एग्जांपल एडुक्रेट निकरेट श्यामासु अङ्गं चकितहरिणी प्रेक्षणे दृष्टिपातः गण्डच्छायां शशिनिशिखिनां बर्हबारेषु केशान् उत्पश्यामि प्रतनुषु नदीवीचिषु भ्रूविलासान् हन्त एकस्मिन्नपि क्वचिदपि न ते भीरुसादृश्यमस्ति हि ट्रैड् हिस् लेवल् बेस्ट् टु यूस् दट् अलङ्कारं श्यामासु अङ्गं चकित उल्लेखालङ्कार बट् स्टिल् एट् दि एण्ड् हिस् फोकस् वास् ओन्ली इन् द रसं टु to say how the yaksha is separated from the yakshi and he is saying I could not find even one similarity between you and any of the natural objects that I see in front of me I could not spend my time looking at the pankajam or looking at the deer somewhere where I could mama vinodaha jayeta तथा एकमपि वस्तु न आसीत् सो हि एंड्स विद दैट एंड गिव्स फोकस टू दैट अंगिरसम विच इज द विप्रलमशंकर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सो यत्नेन अंगत्वे प्रत्यवेक्षणम ही हैज टू मेक एन एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट टू पुट इट एज एन अप्रधान वस्तु अलंकार ओके सो विवक्षा तत्परत्वेन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट विच आई डोंट थिंक और ओनली अदर अलंकारिकास हैव यूज्ड हिज कॉन्सेप्ट एंड taken it further the first, probably Anandavardhana is the first and foremost who has, because he has talked about rasam, he has said how it should be used. These alankaras actually are only an anga, and how they have to be placed in a rasadvani sthala. Vivaksha tatparatvena nangitvena kadachana kalecha grahana tyagau na ati nirvahana ishita. Ishita, eshita, nirvahana eshita. Ichcha, ichcha na bhavita, bhavitavya. Nirviudhavapi cha angatve yatnena pratyavekshanam rupakadir alankara vargasya angatva sadhanam. Next he starts examples for each and every one. First example itself is from Shakuntala. Doubt edhadirka? Any doubts? Okay, you know.